Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 1998 RAQ Australian Fashion Design Awards. I'm Frank Warwick. Behind me, magnificent Brisbane City Hall. Since 1930, the superb heritage-listed building has been one of the most prominent and distinctive landmarks of our capital city. Surrounded by a variety of convention rooms and public facilities is the Great Hall. It's been transformed each of the past 7 years to stage Queensland's premier fashion event. And each year, the Retailers Association of Queensland has made the awards bigger and better, ensuring the RAQ Australian Fashion Design Awards is a prestigious and exciting celebration of our national fashion industry. In just a moment, we're going to join your hosts, Melissa Downs and Tony Johnson, to see what Australia's top designers have to offer. But first, let's cross to Robin Bailey as she meets some of the celebrities making sure of their places to sample this feast of fashion.
Thank you, Frank. And to find out what everyone is wearing on this night of nights, I'm at the red carpet in the foyer of City Hall. Tracy Challenor, weekend newsreader for Channel 7, you look stunning.
Thank you, Robin. So do you.
Who made your dress?
It was Kerry Zinnias from Brides and Lace in the City.
Okay, in this category, students are to nominate which category their entry is to appear in, and it must comply with the judging criteria of that category in the open section.
Students may only enter once. It may be a single entry or a pair, which is a related story. The entry is to be shown on one or two female or male models in any combination.
Entry is from the Innisfail Special School Group from Johnston TAFE. Entitled Brief to Rainforest, it was created by 9 intellectually handicapped students from the Innisfail Special School. The rain cloud hat reflects the torrential rain, while North Queensland's barrier reef, fish, wildlife and lush rainforests are represented on the hessian and silk dress. Well done.
Jones from the Morden Institute of TAFE has entered this next outfit in the wearable art category as well. This kimono raincoat style dress in vibrant colours of pink, orange, green, yellow and blue reflects the near millennium fantasy of the Japanese city at night, which has been made electric by neon lights.
Melissa, our next entry, listen to this, is from Angela Klein from Morton Institute of TAFE for the wearable art category. This garment is a creative exploration of an everyday item. The sophistication and style of retro chairs and chaise lounges have been transformed to convert the comfort and design of furniture into the restrictions of fashion.
Dale Cornell from RMIT in Victoria has nominated this entry in the wearable art category, entitled The Return of the Yellow Peril. It's not an outfit for the faint-hearted. The elements of this dress are designed to confuse the senses. It features hand-printed silks in tones of yellow, orange and red with a blue highlight.
Maria Kouvidis from Morton Institute of TAFE presents this next entry, which was inspired by the galaxies of outer space. Nominated for the wearable art category, this garment is made from aluminium, glass beads, plastic tubing and, wait for it, wire. The lighted movement of outer space have truly been captured in this very unique garment.
Our next entry is from Kelly Lee Merrin from the Kalula Institute of TAFE on the Sunshine Coast. This three-piece Japanese bridal gown was inspired by the new life and growth in Hiroshima. In colours of ivory, gold and shot red, this creation features a silk overcoat and a red embroidered kimono. A wig has been added to create an authentic Japanese look.
Angela Dixnow from the Morton Institute of TAFE has designed this swimwear entry. Inspired by Japanese stencil designs, these embroidered unisex swimsuits can be worn by men or women in any combination. In stunning black and white, this collection features a two-piece swimsuit with strapless top and hipster-style pants. He also wears a two-piece suit consisting of a single-style top and cheeky boy-leg shorts.
Children's wear entry was designed by Luis Piscucci from the Morton Institute of TAFE. The first garment in royal blue features a strapless wrap top and three-quarter length pants, while the second outfit features pale pink hipsters layered with an A-line skirt and matched with a halter neck top.
Next entry is from Hua Suk Lee from Morton Institute of TAFE, who has created this stunning silk lurex evening gown for the haute couture evening category. A dramatic raised neckline accentuates the gown's figure-hugging silhouette. At the back, a teardrop window perfectly balances the sweeping fishtail hemline. An unforgettable gown for an unforgettable occasion.
From the Morton Institute of TAFE is the designer of this next entry for the Evening Collections category. This slender, graceful evening gown was inspired by ancient Greece and its astronomically linked mythology. The diamond beaded cowl back in pastel blue evokes an image of the starry night sky.
Philipusen from Brisbane TAFE has designed this next entry for the haute couture evening category. Entitled Morning Mist and Dew, this dress has been hand-painted with grey silk dyes using a salt technique. This fluid, bias-draped silk georgette gown encourages your eyes to follow the rouleau web in anticipation of an encounter with its owner.
What a reaction. I think we can say that the audience believes each and every one is a winner.
They loved it, and no doubt a lot of supporters at home as well. Okay, to find out our first winner for 1998, let's cross to our Master of Ceremonies, Frank Warwick.
Thank you very much, Tony. With me now is Paul Braddy, the Minister for Employment, Training, Industrial Relations, whose responsibilities include TAFE Queensland, which continues to provide the fashion industry with, as you can see, a lot of skilled and very marketable graduates. So, who is going to be the most excited TAFE student this year, Paul?
Well, the winner of TAFE Queensland Student Design is Kelly Lee Merrin.
Congratulations, Kelly. Kelly's creation was the three-piece Japanese bridal gown, inspired by new life and growth in Hiroshima, with colours of ivory, gold and shot red. Kelly Lee Merrin attends the Kalula Institute of TAFE. She lives on the Sunshine Coast. She's been designing for 10 years, won her first RAQ award in 1992 when she was the youngest winner ever, aged just 14. Receiving her statuette from Minister Braddy, our first winner this year, the TAFE Queensland Student Design winner, Kelly Lee Merrin.
Thank you, Frank, and congratulations, Kelly Lee Merrin. And as they would say in Japanese, omedetou gozaimasu.
Very good. We'll be back after the break with Children's Wear.
Oh,